In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Well, we're celebrating today the feast day of St. Ignatius Loyola. St. Ignatius, founder of the Jesuit order. He lived in the 16th century. He died in 1556. That's just 2 years before our own John Sugar was born. And the order he founded became a very important feature of the church in what's called the post-Reformation era. A very powerful, very influential order indeed. He was actually a soldier until about the age of 30, when he was badly injured by a cannonball. In his convalescence, he became much more motivated by spiritual things, but retained a great sort of practicality and a great sort of sense of organisation. He founded the Order of Jesuits, which were known for their practicality in following the instructions, particularly the instructions of the Holy Father. If you want to get at some essence of the teaching of Ignatius and his practice, I think it's best done by and distinguishing the Jesuits from other religious orders. I think the best way to do this is with a joke. So if you'll forgive me, I'll tell you a joke. There were three members of religious orders together for a conference. There was a Franciscan, there was a Dominican, and there was a Jesuit. Now, if you know anything about these orders, you'll understand the joke, but you don't really need to know all that much, really. And anyway, they were having a meeting, and they were discussing things, and the light went out. So the Franciscan started to preach about the importance of poverty and understanding the needs of the poor, and being without the light meant that we could have a greater sense of our own inadequacy and our need of God and all the gifts he's given us. The Dominican, on the other hand, he started to preach about the marvellous gift of light and God and Jesus as the light of the world and light in darkness and the mystical properties of light. The Jesuit went out and got a light bulb. That, in a nutshell, tells you about the Jesuits and their whole approach to spirituality and in particular St. Ignatius's practice of the retreat as well and his spiritual teaching is a very practical way of doing things. So you get the gist of it. I'm not going to preach about St. Ignatius directly, but there's a nutshell, and it is a nutshell. So as we come together to celebrate this Mass, we offer for the soul of Neil Wilkinson, let us call to mind our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who raised up St. Ignatius of Loyola in your church to further the greater glory of your name, grant that by his help we may imitate him in fighting the good fight on earth, and merit to receive with him a crown in heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever. Amen. Please be seated for our readings from Scripture. Thank you, sister. You're the last one left standing up, so that must be you.
A reading from the prophet Jeremiah. At the beginning of the reign of Jehoiakim, son of Josiah, king of Judah, this word was addressed to Jeremiah by the Lord. The Lord says this, stand in the court of the temple of the Lord to all the people of the towns of Judah who come to worship in the temple of the Lord, you must speak all the words I have commanded you to tell them. Do not omit any syllable. Perhaps they will listen and each turn from his evil way. If so, I shall relent and not bring the disaster on them which I intended for their misdeeds. Say to them, the Lord says this, if you will not listen to me, by following my law, which I put before you, by paying attention to the words of my servant, the prophet, whom I sent so persistently to you. Without your ever listening to them, I will treat this temple as I treated Shiloh, and make this city a curse for all the nations of the earth. The priests and prophets and all the people heard Jeremiah say these words in the temple of the Lord. When Jeremiah had finished saying everything that the Lord had ordered him to say to all the people, the priests and prophets seized hold of him and said, "You shall die. Why have you made this prophecy in the name of the Lord? This temple will be like Shiloh, and this city will be desolate and uninhabited." And the people were all crowding around Jeremiah in the temple of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In your great love, answer me, O God.
In your great love, answer me, O God.
More numerous than the hairs of my head are those who hate me without cause. Those who attack me with lies are too many for my strength. How can I restore what I have never stolen?
In your great love, answer me, O God.
It is for you that I suffer taunts, that shame covers my face, that I have become a stranger to my brothers, an alien to my own mother's sons. I burn with zeal for your house, and taunts against you fall on me.
In your great love, answer me, O God.
This is my prayer to you, my prayer for your favor. In your great love, answer me, O God, with your help that never fails.
In your great love, answer me, O God.
Alleluia, alleluia. Accept God's message for what it really is, God's message and not some human thinking. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Coming to his hometown, Jesus taught the people in their synagogue in such a way they were astonished and said, "Where did the man get this wisdom and these miraculous powers? This is the carpenter's son, surely. Is not his mother the woman called Mary, and his brothers James and Joseph and Simon and Jude? His sisters too, are they not all here with us? So where did the man get it all?" And they would not accept him. But Jesus said to them, "A prophet is only despised in his own country and in his own house." And he did not work many miracles there because of their lack of faith. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I said I wasn't going to preach about St. Ignatius. I'm not, but there is a connection between what I'm going to say. And rather than offer a prize for somebody working it out, it's about the name of Jesus. The Jesuits, the name Jesuit comes from the name of Jesus. And so this homily, which is about the gospel, is also a sort of a prompting some thoughts about the name of Jesus. And they would not accept him. We concentrate so much, so rightly, on Jesus' message of love for God and our neighbour, his parables of the forgiving Father and the Good Samaritan, his compassion in healing the sick and giving sight to the blind, his feeding of the 5,000, so much on Christ the Good Shepherd, his loving and sacred heart, that we might miss the basic fact. Many people were disturbed by him, troubled by his teaching, threatened by the sight of the crowds who gathered round him. They would not accept him. We might think it was just a few Pharisees, just random Romans who ruled with swift brutality, but no. His own village, the people who knew him from childhood, the ones who knew his family, they refused to accept him too. It is this rejection which made his heart sacred, this rejection which turned his blood precious, this rejection which led to his passion and resurrection, and to our own salvation. The very name of Jesus is a challenge to all who hear it, not so easy to accept, often a focus of opposition, division, persecution. And yet this name is the reason why he is so much more than just any other historical figure, however great, but the Son of God, the Word made flesh, the Saviour of the world. This is the place where we'd normally have bidding prayers, because we don't exactly or precisely, but we do remember particularly today the holy souls, those who've passed from this life. Their names are displayed on the board. Apart from Neil Wilkinson, it's displayed on almost everyone. We pray for him especially today at this Mass. But we have a general prayer for the holy souls now, and then during communion, we'll see those names again displayed on this screen. Let us pray. O gentlest heart of Jesus, ever present in the Blessed Sacrament, ever consumed with burning love for the poor captive souls in purgatory, have mercy on the soul of your departed servants. Bring them from the shadows of exile to the bright home of heaven, where, we trust, you and your Blessed Mother Mary have woven for them a crown of unfailing bliss. Eternal rest grant to them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. Amen. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
Sisters, that my sacrifice and yours, pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice of my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. May these offerings we make to you as we celebrate St. Ignatius be pleasing, Lord God, and grant that the sacred mysteries which you have made the fount of all holiness may sanctify us too in the truth, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Ignatius you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Saviour of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Bernard our Bishop, William and David his assistants, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Neil Wilkinson, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with St. Thomas More, with Blessed John Sugar, St. Ignatius, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever. Amen. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And let's greet one another here and all over the world with the peace of Christ. Peace be with you all. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ. The blood of Christ. Communion antiphon. Thus says the Lord, I have come to cast fire on the earth, and how I wish that it were kindled. Well, we're coming to the conclusion of our Mass now. Thank you for those who've gathered online. It seems to be almost exactly the same number every day, about 32, which is, I don't know if it's the same 32 people or whatever, but I couldn't check up on that, actually. But anyway, it's great to welcome you all here with us. And those of us who are in church as well, it's a beautiful day here in Cannock, and I'm told it's going to be a really good day all day today. So take care, stay safe. We know that although we're emerging from lockdown, there are lots of hiccups and problems along the way. I'm not going to give you the news bulletin as well as the weather forecast, but it's a difficult time. So do keep all those people in your prayers who are finding things difficult. I now invite those who are at home to make their own act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Holy Sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I passionately desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my soul, so that I may unite myself wholly to you, now and forever. Amen. Stand now for our final prayers. Let us pray. May the sacrifice of praise which we have offered with thanksgiving in honour of St. Ignatius, O Lord, bring us to exalt your majesty without end. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Now something for those at home.